this afternoon against a Republican resolution condemning Speaker Nancy Pelosi's conduct at the State of the Union. Here now is Indiana Republican Congressman Jim Banks. Congressman, great to see you. Thanks for coming in again. You know, I think it's fair to say that most Americans want to move on right now. A big contingent of Democrats want to stick on this, but most Americans want to move on. Nevertheless, we have Jerry Nadler saying he's going to subpoena John Bolton and continue the process of investigating the whole Ukraine mess. I just wonder, do you think the Democrats have learned anything about the public feeling on this investigation?
It appears that even Jerry Nadler hasn't talked to Speaker Pelosi about that. It appeared that she was blindsided by that news, which tells us something. The Democrat Party is in a spiral. They're spiraling out of control. This has been a really bad week for Democrats at the national level, Democrats in Congress. A really good week for President Trump, perhaps the best week the president has had since he was elected in 2016. So you're sort of seeing that and feeling that. That's what I feel on the House floor among Democrats. They've had enough of this as much as the American people have had, but they don't know where to turn. They're confused. They don't know what to do next because they know that, at least at this point, they've lost this war over this shameful impeachment mess.
Hi, Congressman. The thing is that, you know, Republicans are putting points on the board. Should we actually engage in a tit for tat in terms of this resolution or other means in terms of trying to attack the speaker? Or should we just focus on what the president has done, what the president has accomplished, and what he wants to do and bring that message to the American people?
Well, I somewhat agree. It's time to move on and get back to work on the issues that matter. And the president laid out what those issues are in the State of the Union address and in his remarks at the White House, which I was there to listen to today, when he talked about infrastructure, he talked about prescription drug cost, overall health care reform. That's what the president wants to focus on. But there's also a component of this where you have to recognize that many of us never want to see another president go through what this president has gone through. And that means that we do need to go back and investigate the leaker. We need to investigate Joe and Hunter Biden. Lindsey Graham said this week that he is intent upon doing that in the Senate Judiciary Committee, having hearings that are focused on that. We can do that and go back to work in a bipartisan way on the issues that matter. But no president, bottom line, no president should ever have to go through what this president has gone through. You heard the president apologize to his family today in front of the cameras at the White House, in front of the American people tuning in live to watch him. He had to apologize to his family for dragging them being dragged through this travesty that is this shameful impeachment, partisan impeachment process that they've been dragged through over the past several months. That should never happen again.
So, Congressman, this is Gary Kaltbaum. The Democratic presidential candidates are all looking to raise taxes. Bernie Sanders is even going as to $29,000 and up to raise taxes. Any chance of tax cut 2.0 before the election, even though we know it's not going to get through, but to at least to offset what they're trying to do?
I hope the Senate will go there and force the House's hand. I don't see Speaker Pelosi going down that track because she knows tax cuts 2.0 could be just as popular or more popular than the first version of the tax cuts. I mean, the bottom line, you heard Speaker Pelosi's delusional remarks about the Obama economy being better than the Trump economy. We all know that's not the case. The polling was also clear this week when an overwhelming majority of Americans said they're better off now than they were the day that Barack Obama left office. The American people see what they get under this president, under Republican leadership in the Congress by growing this historically good economy. And another round of tax cuts could even make it better.
Robert? Congressman, so the question was about whether Speaker Pelosi, there should be a vote on her conduct, which is a complete farce. The idea that we would have a vote and that you, I think you would agree with that. But then you bring up Hunter Biden and you bring up Joe Biden, but then you don't want to see Bolton, who was actually in the room. I mean, you can't have it both ways. Either you want to continue this tit for tat or you actually want to move on. And by the way, the House has over 300 bills they passed sitting on the Senate table ready to be approved. Gun reform, health care and prescription. That stuff hasn't been moved. Don't you want to see some of the stuff that you all voted on be approved? Or it sounds like you want to go backwards if you want to start going after this stuff.
Really, honestly, I don't want to see a number of the radical big government bills that have passed out of the House go anywhere at all. So I'm glad that Mitch McConnell.
Well,
and
you liked
the
USMCA when they brought in labor standards and environmental standards because you voted
for it. And Speaker Pelosi held USMCA hostage for a year when farmers and businesses in my district could have been benefiting from it all along. So the difference is stark. It's clear between Speaker Pelosi and the national Democrats who are running for president and their agenda versus President Trump's agenda. I have no question standing here today before this camera and speaking to you and your listeners that President Trump is going to be reelected in November because of this strong economy, a strong track record of rebuilding the military, keeping America safe and secure, what he's done for veterans all over this country.
No, but Congressman, you've recently lost both the governorships in Kentucky and you lost the governorship in Louisiana, and you lost 41 House seats that flipped red to blue. So I think the jury's out.
Final question, quick answer, Congressman.
The election day in 2020 is going to be a lot different when the Trump voters come out and vote, and they're going to reelect President Trump, and they're going to elect Republicans up and down the ballot. I have no question about that because Democrats have had a disastrous week from fumbling the Iowa caucuses on Monday to Nancy Pelosi's childish behavior at the State of the Union address. They're giving this president his reelection.
We're going to be talking more about the caucus coming up.
I agree with you about the caucus.
Okay, we'll end with an agreement.
We're
way overdue for a break. Congressman, thank you very much. Good to see you, Jim Banks.